What's up? And this is for the Trucker Dog Channel. Hope y'all can see me okay. And I'm in my beat up t-shirt. This shirt is my old big dog shirt. It's been at it for years. I'm going to put my hat on. I hope y'all can hear me okay. Am I on? Let's see. Hold on. I want to make sure this is connected. You know, one day I'm going to do a review on this thing. I love the sound on it. There were just a couple issues, but it's a pretty good one. So anyway, I hope it get connected. I won't be connected to the phone. Yeah, should have connected to the phone. So I wanted to kind of just do a quick update, let you guys know where I'm at, how close I am to coming back. I think I got about 3, maybe 4 weeks left of physical therapy. They asked me when I wanted to go back. Right now we're working stairs. I'm out the cast. I'm out the boot. I'm off the crutches. I'm off the walker. I'm off the roller. And I was using a cane for the last few weeks, but I have determined I'm going to come off that too. What I've done is set goals for myself. And I also have been doing my own little walking and exercises here in the room. And at night when the family, I'm staying with a friend of mine, when they're asleep, sometimes I walk. When they're not home, I walk around the house and make a little area for me to walk. Today I've been doing these things where I'm picking my legs up real high and bending them because they get really stiff and sore. But I got to build up stamina as far as standing because I really did have quite a bit of atrophy left. So my goal is to actually be back probably about the third week of May. That's my goal. To be back hopefully on a truck, or I'll have to see how the company I'm with, how they're going to bridge me back in. I got to go because while I was down, my DOT physical was due. So I want to get that taken care of here shortly. And probably in the next few weeks once I'm walking better, because you got to be in shape to do your physical. As far as shape, as far as the routine physical. Getting that done and out the way. I've already did my doctor visit to make sure I got everything in case they have any questions about anything that I'm on, any meds. Sometimes they will. I've lost a significant amount of weight because I started doing something different with my diet while I was here. Because I was down and not as active, I started cutting meats. And because when I would eat meat, and don't get me wrong, I'm not trying to say I'm a vegetarian by any means, because I love a steak every so often. And occasionally I like chicken. I don't like fried chicken as much, but I like, as I've gotten older, I used to love fried chicken, but I'm not as big now. I don't like a lot of fried foods because they're heavy. But I started really kind of listening to my body. If my body said something was heavy, or I felt like oh, it's like a weight on my stomach, I just don't mess with it. So I've actually started eating like veggie burgers, veggie sausage. I started doing more vegetables, veggie burritos, like it's a cold burrito with stuff in it. More vegetables. If I do like spinach, I did fresh sauteed spinach. I'm not a canned good eater too much. There's very few canned good stuff I like. Like I'll do canned refried beans, but I would rather make my own. But since I'm here in somebody else's house, I don't cook to that degree. So some canned stuff I've done, some I haven't. But I've cut a lot of things. Like I saute asparagus, I saute spinach. And that's something I will eat for myself. And so when I went to the doctor, I think my last visit prior to this one, I was somewhere between 405, 410. In this visit, I was 380. So I've lost a significant amount. My incident happened December 13th for my fracture, and I've been down since then, and we're now almost to May. So I'm almost like 5-6 months in. So the bounce back has been hard, probably one due to age, two due to probably some of my size but the biggest part was that I was down for, I was non-weight-bearing for so long, so I wasn't able to use a leg, and only one of my legs I was using. So the right leg is sore because I've been just mainly been doing all the work, the knee and stuff. So I'm kind of bringing that back. And then the left leg, where the accident happened on the ankle, that's just trying to build a muscle back so it can handle me. But the good thing is that I've lost some weight. And that's going to be kind of a journey I'm going to be looking at going back into transportation. Also, I'm sorry, I didn't say Happy Easter, everybody. I've been looking at a lot of trucking videos because I know I'm bridging back into the industry. So I've been looking at a lot of trucking videos right now. Like I told you in the last video, apparently there's a whole bunch of drama going on a couple different channels. You know, one gentleman, I guess he got into a new lease purchase. The truck is not a great truck. He's in a Volvo. I'm not going to give names. Had a lot of problems with the Volvo, which I kind of giggle because I remember back when I was in 2009 with Swift. And they had the Volvo fleet, and that's the fleet I came into when they had nothing but Volvos. And I remember coming out, I tested out in Memphis at the Swift Yard in Memphis, and they gave me virtually a brand new single sleeper Volvo. The first loadout, lost power, no charge, nothing would turn on, and they had to come out and jump the truck. I had to sleep one night in the truck in Arkansas, Harrison, Arkansas, very cold. And I had to sleep in that truck with no power. They said, can you get through the night? Because I was sitting in the doctor's, a hot mess. One of the reasons I hate dry van loads. That started it, and I'm just not a dry van person. I love reefer. You have to sit and wait with reefer, but I like reefer. I like the whole concept of reefer. There's a lot of reasons I like reefer, and when I get back into it, I'm going to explain it. I'm not going to get into it now, but I'm going to explain why I like reefer. Some people don't like reefer. I like the reefer mainly delivers. Usually got to be there early in the morning or late in the evening. I like that because I like to drive nights, prefer to days. I drive anything, but I prefer nights. Most drivers don't like nights. And there's just, I'm strategic in a lot of what I like in trucking. So you have to find what fits you. Now, I'll drive any hours. Like I said, I've driven everything from border to border all the way to Canada. I have areas of the country I don't like driving over others. I hate driving California. Everything east of Pennsylvania, I can't stand. I love Pennsylvania and everything between, everything that is west of California, up to the north, down to the south, and all the way up to PA, love driving it. And once you get past PA into the little eastern states that aren't truck friendly, just like California ain't truck friendly, can't stand it. So those are my states that I don't particularly care for. And so we'll see. So the goal of the channel, this was one of the part of this that I wanted to do. I've been sitting here thinking, what do I want to do with my trucking channel? Because I really believe that it should have purpose. Part of it is you guys are going to be following just some of my own journey. I'm vlogging because I like to vlog. I'm doing it because it's enjoyable to me. I used to do some other stuff on YouTube a long time ago. I don't do that anymore. Right now it's this and the Christian channel. That's it. My Facebook is under a different name, which I'll probably link that below. And I may end up tying videos between trucking and that in my Facebook name, because my Facebook name is Getting Saucy. So if anybody wants to join up on my Facebook page, it's Getting Saucy. I'll have to put the link below because it's not spelled how it's said. It's spelled a little differently. Some people are already on my Facebook page. And I know, like I said, I don't know if a trucking company looks at this or whatever, but if another person who's a trainer looks at this, that's really going to be my trucking focus, is training. I think, you know, and everything I enjoyed about trucking, one was my training experience in school. Two was doing training. I love to train, whether it's in a corporate environment or whether it's in a trucking environment. I love training. And three, because my training experiences have been horrific in two major trucking companies. My Werner training experience was not the best. I had one lady who was really good, but her goal later on was to try to get into the corporate offices. And I'll tell that story later, because that was kind of the make and break with me and Werner, because I had been in and out of hotels between the two sucky trainers they gave me in the beginning, and then they gave me a really good trainer at the end. But then her goal, like I said, was to try to get in the offices. So she wanted to get me off the truck so she could try to maneuver her way into the offices, because we had talked on the truck and she was using some of the ideas I was giving her and relaying it back to corporate. So then they had questions for her, and so there was a whole bunch of stuff going on with that. We're done. My final, thing was I went over to Swift, and the trucking instructor, the trainer I had at Swift, the first one, he was okay. My problem with him is that he worked for an owner op, and him and his owner op were trying to convince me to come over and work for the owner op. And I'm sitting up here on the truck with you, and your owner op ain't paying you on time. There was maintenance issues on our truck. I'll go into that a little bit later, because that was a trip. We couldn't even get out the path. I'll tell this story. We couldn't get out the driver's side door. It broke during my training period. And I finally told him, look, this is unsafe. You need to get this fixed, because otherwise I'm going to ask to get off this truck. If something happened, we can't even get out this doggone door. We happen to go out the passenger door, and his owner op can't afford to get it fixed. That's crazy as heck. And then you ain't getting paid on time. It was just some crazy stuff. Dude is hungry. I'm like, okay, you trying to convince me to come work for somebody who ain't paying you And hey, you know, I'm sharing some food with you because you ain't got no food. That's crazy. You ain't got no food. You ain't got no money. That's crazy. I mean, as far as a trainer, he was okay. My training experience at the existing company I'm at, I don't give no names, that has been interesting. The first person I had, I liked this individual because they pretty much let me just do. It's like, dude, you can drive. But they had less experience than me. And there were things that they didn't know. So, I'm huge on the fact that we need something dealing with training in the industry. And if you want to be a trainer, I really believe we need to talk about it. I see videos where you see people take you through backing and take you through shifting. They ask you some questions. But I really think that we need to maybe put something together for the trainer and how to maybe help you be a better trainer. And I think I can bridge some of the corporate skill set and ideas to this channel and hopefully help somebody that way. But it also, I think, will help new drivers in identifying a good trainer to get under. I'm praying that when I go back, because like I said, I had 32 hours left of my 200 hours. I'm praying when I go back that that's all I got to do, or if they would let me just test out, I would be extraordinarily happy because I hate being on a truck with somebody else, especially if they're not a competent trainer and they got personality issues. I'm going to be very clear when I go back and just say, look, you know, whoever you give me, I would prefer a company driver. I don't want to own ops, because the last chick I had was, I won't even go to half of what I'm thinking with her, because I even have some questions as far as how this happened, but we won't go there. I'm gonna let it go and just say, well, God is in control. But I'm praying that they will give me a company driver, somebody who's not a butthole, somebody who's not a perv, and somebody who just let me get my driving done and let me go and test out, and I move on and they move on, and somebody who's decent. That's all I had. The first person, she was decent. There were some issues there I won't go into. There were some issues as far as, in my opinion, focus, and what else will I say? There was focus issues. There were cleanliness issues. Very sweet person. I like the person as far as a general person. Very nice person. Definitely the second chick could have used some of her personality. But the second chick, she had issues too. So, anyway, I'm just praying for it. My goal is God bless me with a decent trainer and not any drama when I go back. So, hopefully just a smooth transition back, and then a smooth transition through my testing, and then get a company truck, do my little company drive for 4 to 6 months, take care of my stuff, get my financial stuff in order. And then I'm looking to buy property in Texas and put a tiny home on it, and then I want to homestead it. So that's going to take me, I'm estimating a year, maybe a year and a half to get all that set up, maybe sooner. We just have to see how everything rolls. But by 2018, I'm hoping to own the property and then begin the process of getting it cleaned off. It doesn't need a lot. It just needs, I think, a little bit of weeds and stuff, and may have a tree removed. Might have both trees removed. I'm not sure yet. And then I'm really interested in the properties behind it and to the right of it. I really like to own the whole block, but right now it's like 0.73 acres and it's cheap. So that's the goal. As far as the tiny house is looking, that's something else I'm going to probably have here on the channel. You might see some of that journey with me. I've got a couple of different ones I'm looking at. I really wanted, if I could have, and found somebody to build the home from the ground up. There are some houses where I've been looking at different tiny homes and what I want. My problem now is that because tiny homes have become popular, you got a bunch of people out here, the commercial builders who are doing it, in my opinion, are kind of ripping folks off. It went from between $12,000 and, let's say, $30,000, $40,000, now to where these people are charging between $60,000 and $100,000. If you're spending that kind of money, you might as well buy a regular house on a regular piece of property and a regular piece of land and go ahead and get the 1,600 square feet. It doesn't make sense to go with a small house. The goal of the tiny house was to cut your costs, be able to pay cash, and not be in debt. Now you got people who, like, you know, and I understand entrepreneurship, but the purpose behind it has kind of gone out the window. But I found a company called Arch Cabins. That's Henry. Henry, if I pass gas, Henry runs from behind my butt. I just have to share that. It's funny to me. And so, if I do that, Henry Red, because I have a little gas today. Y'all say hi to Mr. Henry. They've been keeping me, because my play niece's dogs, they've been keeping me company through the broken leg. But if I have a company called Arch Cabins that I've researched a lot. I've had a lot of time to do some research. So what Arch Cabins is they actually have a kit. It's like the military Quonset huts, and they have different sizes. You can go through everything from like $3,000-$4,000 all the way up to just around under $20,000. And what they do is they build the outer shell, the floor part of it, the ribs of it. And then if you want them to do more than that, it may cost you a little bit more, like stairs, because they will put a loft in there. I really don't, I'm going to have the loft in there, but that'll be my guest room area. I'm not going to be upstairs. I want a bedroom downstairs. So I'm looking at their, I think it's their 20 by 40 or their 24 by 40. I can't remember. It's one of the two. I'm looking at, they have a couple. And they have like several different sizes, but I'm looking at that one. The one I'm looking at is just around 800 square feet without the loft. And then I'm sure the loft may add, it may just put it under 1,000 or so square feet. That's what I'm looking at. And I'm doing a steel, I want to do the steel framed. It's steel and concrete, so they put like concrete posts with the steel in it. And I'm looking at that as far as my foundation part, and they'll level it out. And they come out and put it up, and I think that's going to probably run me close to maybe, with the end caps, 20, and then you have to have somebody come in and frame it out. So I kind of sat here and drawn up like how I want the bedroom, where I want the kitchen, doors and windows, things like that. But it's built like the old military Quonset huts, and it's called Arched Cabins. Y'all check that out. It's kind of cool. But my goal is to be totally debt-free. I know there's some people on here, truckers on here, YouTube, and they're looking to make $100,000 and buy a Mercedes. I'm 48 years old. I'm just trying to set myself up for retirement so I can hopefully get out of this by the time I'm maybe 58 years old, maybe, and then have some money set around and I can do my little homesteading, and maybe sooner than that. Or maybe get a couple trucks and then have people drive for me and brokerage my own freight or work for a company where I got a good income. I'm not, you know, if I become a millionaire, but if I can have enough to set me up for retirement, have a decent income coming in, you know. So that's kind of my goal. We'll see. But yeah, I'm going to, the goal of the channel is going to be to train, guys. It's going to be to train. Some upcoming videos I'm going to do. I'm going to talk about the trucking school that I went to. I'm going to talk about, you know, do you want to do trucking school? Do you want to go company as far as go to a company and then be indentured for a year? You know, I'm going to probably be more biased towards the trucking school. I'm going to tell one of my friend's experiences. He went through CR England. I did not. And, you know, I'll share that experience. Trucking Bill, I think he's over 30 years in it. So he learned from somebody and was driving for a private owner, which is how he started out back in the day, you know, before logs and e-logs, electronic logs. I'm going to talk about, I might do some product stuff too. I do like seeing that from some of the online truckers, and I have some things, like I bought this cup right here, and I'll put some stuff on that. I'll probably go over that. I'll go over the headset, things that I feel you should have on a truck, especially once I get my truck. You know, I have like a storage unit with stuff in it. I have tools in there. I don't know if I'm going to bring those out for the company truck. For my work, for my truck, when I go lease purchase, I'm going to bring my stuff. I'm going to get it. But for now, it's probably going to stay in storage, or I might just have a second set. I'm not sure yet. Again, I'm praying on whether to do it with the company I'm with. There's some upcoming changes with the company I'm with, so I don't know if I'm going to stay with them for the lease purchase. It really is going to be what that looks like to me. Or if I'm going to go with another company that has what I call a, what's the lease purchase they have? A walk-away lease, which I'm leaning towards more. There's been a couple companies I'm interested in, but we'll see. You know, I'm going to pray about it and just believe God's going to direct me accordingly. Or if I can find a company where I can have my own truck and I get maybe a percentage of the load, I may do that as well. But I don't know. Or train. Like I said, I do like to train, but if I'm okay getting a percentage of the load, not having to train, that would be lovely. That'd be even more lovely. But we'll just have to see which way the cookies crumbles. Oh, what else is going on? Unless I hit the lottery. If I hit the lottery, guys, I'm retired. I'm just saying. I'm retired, and I'll be doing straight ministry and nothing else. Y'all will see the homesteading and settling and doing that. Y'all won't see nothing else besides that. And I'll take you through some of that journey. I'm trying to think what else. But yeah, so I'm going to do that. Oh, I want to do a video on different trucks because I've driven several. I've driven a Peterbilt. I've driven a long nose K-Dub. I've driven Freightliners. I've driven Volvo. I think if I haven't driven any, the one that I haven't driven a Mack, and I haven't driven a Western Star. So those are the two. I'm interested in the Western Star because I hear Western Star is supposed to be a nice truck. I don't know. Peterbilt. I've driven Peterbilt. And I have truck preferences. So I'm a Freightliner person. I love shaky freights. I love the old Freightliner Columbia. I like the Freightliner Cascadia. I like the look of the new 2018 Freightliner Cascadia. But I think what they did, I know what they did. They actually took a lot of hints from Volvo, which I love the interior of Volvo. The Volvo had too many electrical issues. And I love the turning radius of Volvos. Volvos, back when I was driving, I could U-turn a truck on a dime. So I love all of that. I love all of that. So that's some of where this truck channel is going. I hope you guys had a blessed Easter today. You spent it with some family and friends. It was positive for you. I'm going to get up here and probably make some tostadas here later. So I'm trying to figure out what I'm going to do for dinner. And I think I'm going to do some tostadas later on. I got some refried beans in a can. I'm trying to use up all my little food over here. Because like I said, it's going to be about, rough estimate, 3 weeks. It's going to go fast. I got this week coming up. That's one. Next week coming up. And then I go back for a reevaluation mid-May. And I think on that evaluation, if I'm doing the stairs well enough and I can and get up on a truck, I'm good. We've already started working on double clutch, but when I go back, I'm going to have a preference for a automatic. One, because of the ankle. An ankle's fine, but there's some strenuous stuff with clutching. And so I know how to drive a 10-speed, but I know that when I get my truck, I'm going to want an automatic because I'm looking at fuel economy. When I get my lease purchase, I want automatic. I'm going to fuel economy. I know some people, I ain't got no get up and go. Well, you can have to get up and go and waste the fuel. I'd rather just get there slow and steady. And as long as it can get to the speed limit, we straight. It might not have all the power, but I'm not doing heavy haul. I'm going to be a reefer driver. That's my forte. Anywho, we'll talk about the move to Texas. What I tell you. So let's go through everything. Talk about move Texas. I went out. That's the goal. Taking care of financial stuff. Filing business license. I'll probably talk a little bit about how I'm going to do that. I already have my business name, business logo written up. I'm going to go ahead and start filing some of that. I'm doing Chapter 7 for my own personal stuff. I've been looking at a lot of stuff about building business credit. I'm going to try to start working on some of that. What else? During the time once I get back on the truck and get past this freaking refresher going out with a trainer, once I get past that drama, I'm going to, and getting back into a truck, my goal will be to, what's the word I want to use? My ultimate goal will be to, trying to think. Once I get back into everything, my ultimate goal will be to begin to transition into some goals that I've set for myself, and I'll start going through those. Like I said, there'll be more content coming on here. Right now, I don't know that I can do road views, which I love doing road views. What I may do is still get them, but I'll get pictures and then do some still frame pictures to music. I think that's going to be the best way because a lot of the companies, until I can own my own truck, are kind of funky about you filming while you drive. And I know that, I think there's one guy, I like him. You guys, I like Indiana Jack Trucker. I like him and Allie Knight. And I love the road views. And it's funny because as I'm watching, I'm like, I know where that's at. I know, I've been there. So, talk about truck stops too. That's another thing. I would like to see, like, people's favorite truck stops. Like, I have favorite truck stops that I went to in Virginia, Smiley's Fuel City, for example. Obviously, everybody loves Iowa 80. Elk Grove, that's another good one. And Jubitz in Oregon, that's one of my top favorites. I like it because it's like the the outside mall for truckers. It's like a little mall for truckers. It's cool. So those are some of my favorite truck stops. Oh, Seattle, Washington. I think that's a TA. They got a sub called an 18-wheeler. Any trucker who's done that, sub is huge, man. It's like huge. And it's like thick. Everything is in that sub. It's amazing sub. I use them for days. I'm a huge sub person, so I like subs. But, yeah, so talk about a little bit of that and some goals. Anyway, again, I hope y'all have a blessed Easter. And that you spend it with your family. You're being safe out there on the road. And we're just praying for you. And pray to God, him and his angels watch over you. 2-2, y'all.